Students, today we are going to discuss about digital to analog converter. So it's a type of data converter. Before going into detail about this topic, so I would like to brief a small important point that, see, you know, students, KPU is supporting you during this lockdown period by the support of SAP and by connecting all the faculties all over the world, all over Kerala. So in connection with all these things, we are supporting students. So make use of these sessions in the maximum sense. So if you have any doubt in between, please raise. At any point, you can raise. If I am not able to answer the question, I will give the answer to this SRP and they will share with you. So let me start the session. Okay. So digital to analog converters, and it's a data converter. So before going to digital to analog converter, let us see. What is the need of data converters? So here you can see a simple block diagram. Actually, it's a very simple block diagram. So from this block diagram itself, you can understand why we require data converters. So what is actually data converters? You know, transducer. What is transducer? Transducer is actually used to convert energy in one form to another form. Similarly, just similar to that, data converters are those circuits or devices which is used to convert data from one form to another. And we know there are mainly two types of data, analog signals or mainly two types of signals or data, analog signals and digital signals. So if we want to convert analog signal to digital signal, then we need to use a converter which is known as analog digital converter. In the same time, if you want to convert our digital signal to analog signal, then we have to use digital to analog converter. For example, suppose we want to process the temperature that we have measured from a AC or engine or a remote plant. So what we have to do, or how we will process the measured temperature? This measured temperature has to be given to a computer. And you know, temperature or pressure, whatever the physical parameter, all these parameters are analog signal. So if we want to process these signal, we have to give this to a computer. And you know, computer will work based on digital data. So in such case, we need to convert this analog data to digital data. For that, we are using analog to digital converter. In the same time, so if you want to connect, or if you want to give the data from a computer to a speaker, and you know speaker is an analog device, so whereas the data present in the computer will be in the digital form. So we have to connect these digital data to the analog device, that is our speaker. So for that, what we have to do, we have to convert this digital data to the analog form. That's it. In instance, we use the digital to analog converter for converting this digital data to the analog form. So I hope this is clear. So then, coming to digital to analog converter, in this particular session, I'm going to discuss only about digital to analog converter. And I know you are already gone through the session of analog to digital converter in the previous sessions. So here, today we are dealing with only digital to analog converter. So here you can see a simple block. This block represents a DAC, that is digital to analog converter. Already I mentioned it is used to convert this digital data to the analog input. So the input of this DAC will be in digital format. And the digital form the input is converted to the output PA. And you know, see if there are n bits are here. One more thing. Here you can see the input of DAC is represented from D0 to Dn minus 1, that is D0, D1, D2, etc., Dn minus 1. So this particular DAC stands for n-bit DAC, that is the number of bits in the input is n. If it is 2, we will be having only 2 input terminals, that is D0 and D1. So this particular DAC will convert the digital input to the analog output. So depending on the combination of the digital data, this device converts it into the analog voltage. So let us consider this a simple conversion chart for a 2-bit DAC. Here in the x-axis you can see the digital input. So it's a 2-bit AAC. So the combinations are only 00, 01, 10, 11. And the y-axis you can see the analog voltage, which is corresponding to the individual digital input. So for example, the first value when the digital input is 00, the output analog voltage corresponding to that in the y-axis we can say 0. So and you know when the input is 0, the output of course it will be 0. Then the second you can see when the input is 01, that is when the digital input of a DAC is 01, the output corresponding to it is V1. Similarly, for 10 it is V2 and for 11 it is V3. And V3 is the full scale voltage, that is V3 will be obtained only when the all bits in the input of DAC is 1. So that is the maximum input value that we can give to the DAC. So V3 is corresponding to the full scale output voltage of the DAC. And here you can see step size. Step size is the smallest change in the analog output as a result of change in the digital input. So you can see when the input changes from 00 to 01, the output changes from 0 to V1. So this change is known as step size. Also the term resolution, that these two terms are very important to DAC. And resolution is also proportional to the number of bits. So as the number of bits increases, the resolution of the DAC is also increasing. So here I am not going to discuss about the parameters of DAC. So in this section, I will discuss only about the types of DAC, its working, and how we can design a DAC. Okay. So coming to the types of DAC, there are mainly 5 types of DAC. One is binary weighted DAC, and the second one is R2R ladder DAC. Third one is charge scaling DAC. Fourth, cyclic DAC. And put pipeline DAC. Out of these 5 DACs, in this session, I will discuss only about the first two, binary weighted DAC and R2R ladder DAC, because these two are the DACs included in your syllabus. That is, we are dealing with the 6th module of analog integrated circuits EC204. In that 6th module, it is specifically mentioned as binary weighted DAC and R2R ladder DAC. So in this particular session, we will discuss only these two, and the rest you can study by yourself. So coming to the binary weighted DAC, so let us consider a general case, n-bit binary weighted DAC. So whatever, whichever be the DAC, that is whether it is binary weighted DAC or R2R ladder DAC, the main important active component is an op-amp. And you know op-amp, and you have studied more about op-amp from the module 1 to let us say 4th module. Up to 4th module, it was really discussing about op-amp. So op-amp is basically an amplifier which is used to perform almost all mathematical operations. So and it is having two input terminals, positive input terminal and negative input terminal. Positive input terminal is known as non-inverting input terminal. And negative input terminal is known as inverting input terminal. So based on these particular inputs, to which we are applying input signal to the amplifier, the op-amp is mainly divided into two modes of operation. When we are giving input to inverting mode, inverting input terminal, then the op-amp is working in inverting mode. Whereas when we are giving input to non-inverting input terminal, then this particular op-amp is working in non-inverting mode. As the name indicates, inverting mode means there is a phase difference between, there is a phase shift of 180 degree between the input and output of the op-amp. So when we are applying a positive input to the inverting input terminal, the expected output at the output terminal of the op-amp is negative. That is, there is a phase shift of 180 degree between the input and output. Whereas, if you are applying a signal at the non-inverting input terminal, there will not be any phase shift between the input and output. That is, when we are applying a positive signal, we will expect the same polarity at the output also. So, in this particular section, we are using inverting mode amplifier or inverting mode op-amp. So, we will be giving input to the inverting input terminal and non-inverting terminal is connected to ground. Then the rest circuitry for binary weighted DAC is, we have N resistors. For N bit binary weighted DAC, we use N resistors. And the resistor values are 2 raised to 0 R, 2 raised to 1 R, 2 raised to 2 R, etc. 2 raised to N minus 1 R. So here you can see the resistor values. For the first resistor, it is 2 raised to 0 R. Then second, it is 2 raised to 1. Third, it is 2 raised to 2. That is, as we are moving from first resistor to the last resistor, the resistor value is increasing by binary weight. That is 2 raised to 0, 2 raised to 1, 2 raised to 2, etc. 2 raised to n minus 1. Because of this, this particular DAC is known as binary weighted DAC. Now, see here, this number of resistor. So I already mentioned for n bit binary weighted DAC, we use n resistors. So the number of resistor is depending on the number of bits. So for n bit binary weighted DAC, we have n bits. So because of that, we use n resistors. So the bits are represented by Dn minus 1, Dn minus 2, Dn minus 3, etc. D0. Where Dn minus 1 stands for the MSB bit and D0 stands for the LSB bit. That is, once we apply the digital input, we have to give MSB to this particular resistor and whereas LSB to this last resistor. Hope it's clear. And you know, when a resistor is connected to a voltage, there will be a current flow. So for each branch, we can represent a current as I1, I2, I3, etc., IN. And also the feedback resistor RF, the current through RF is denoted as IO. And since it's an inverting mode amplifier, the output is equal to minus IO into RF. The negative sign indicates that there is a phase shift of 180 degree between the input and output. Okay. Now here in this resistor, now let us see the resistors. First we can see the first resistor, that is 2 raised to 0 R. So the, in addition to that, the left side you can see two vertical lines. So these two vertical lines, one line is corresponding to the reference voltage and the second line is corresponding to the ground. So the resistor, you just consider the first resistor, 2 raised to 0 R, just look into that. So one end of the resistor is connected to the inverting input terminal of the op-amp, whereas the other end, so you can see it's a switch, so it's a digital switch and we can control the switch depending on the digital value. So if this particular bit Dn minus 1 is 1, then this switch is connected to V reference. Then if this particular switch is 0, then the switch will be connected. So if the bit is 0, then the switch is connected to ground. Hope it's clear. That is, if the binary digit or the digit value, bit value is 1, then the switch has to connect the resistor to V reference. And if it is 0, the switch has to connect to the ground. The same is for all the switches. That is, if the LSB of the binary digit, LSB of the digital input is 1, then the last resistor 2 raised to n minus 1 has to connect to reference. And if it is 0, it has to connect to ground. Okay? So here we have to keep it in mind that the MSB and LSB position. So don't confuse with these two bits. So MSP is given to 2 raised to 0 R. So normally students will face a feel a confusion here. They will draw the circuit very correctly, and during evaluation time we face all these issues. So they draw the circuit very neatly, but the MSP and LSP position interchange. So then the circuit will become wrong. So we can't give any mark for that. So here you have to always keep it in mind that the MSP Dn minus 1 should always give to 2 raised to 0 R. Whereas LSB D0 is given to 2 raised to n minus 1 R. Now the current I1. So you know when a voltage is applied to a resistor, what is the current through that resistor? It is equal to voltage divided by resistance. So here, for the same, consider the first resistor itself, 2 raised to 0 R. So when this particular bit Dn minus 1 is equal to 1, the switch is connected to V reference. That means the voltage V reference is given to the resistor 2 raised to 0 R. Then what is the current through that resistor when it is connected to V reference? That is, the current I1 is equal to V reference divided by 2 raised to 0 R. Whereas if the bit is 0, then you know this switch will be connected to ground. So the current through the resistor also will be 0. Okay, that is when this switch is connected to V reference, the current I1 is equal to 2 raised to 0 R. So and for second case, I2, what about the current I2? I2 is equal to V reference by 2 raised to 1 R. Similarly, In is equal to V reference by 2 raised to n minus 1 R. So you know, as we are moving from 2 raised to 0 R to 2 raised to n minus 1 R, the value of current is decreasing. So if we are comparing the value of current from I1, I2, I3 or from I1 to In, I1 has the highest value and In has the least value. That is, it is directly related to I1. The high current or highest current is related to, or it is in connection with, more significant bit. So for more significant bit, for MSB we have high current and for LSB we have low current. So like this also you can remember where we have to give MSB or where we have to give LSB. Okay. So I1 is equal to V reference 2 raised to 0 R if Dn minus 1 equal to 1, 0 if Dn minus 1 equal to 0. So in general, you know, I1 is related to Dn minus 1. So in general, we can write I1 is equal to V reference by 2 raised to 0 R into Dn minus 1. So that is the current expression of current through the resistor 2 raised to 0 R. That is, I1 is equal to V reference by 2 raised to 0 R into Dn minus 1. So if Dn minus 1 equal to 1, then I1 is equal to V reference by 2 raised to 0 R. If Dn minus 1 equal to 0, then I1 equal to 0.
Then, ma'am.
Hello?
I need to interrupt, ma'am. Could you make it more louder, please?
Oh, is it not audible?
It's audible, ma'am, but the voice is low. So please, could you make it louder?
Okay. So, apa ituvare parnadonna clear aayirunnille?
Ma'am, clear aayirunnu. Edakkedakke ma'amude voice low aayi povunnundu.
Okay. Anyway. So once again, I will just read from this previous point. So I1 is equal to V reference by 2 raised to 0 R if Dn minus 1 equal to 1. I1 equal to 0 if Dn minus 1 equal to 0. So we can write in connection with Dn minus 1 as I1 is equal to V reference by 2 raised to 0 R into Dn minus 1. Okay. So in addition to the current I1 to In, we can consider one more current as I. So here we can see, so this I is current through the op-amp or current towards the op-amp. So at this particular junction, the incoming current is divided into two. So one is to the op-amp and another one is to the feedback resistor RL. And what is the value of this particular current? You know, it is zero. Ideally, it is zero. Why? Because the input impedance of the op-amp is ideally infinity. So the input impedance of the op-amp is ideally infinity. Because of that, the current driven by the op-amp is zero. So you know, infinite resistance will drive zero current. So the because of the infinite input impedance of the op-amp, the current driven by the op-amp is zero. So this whole IO, that is the all the incoming current will be going to the feedback resistor IO. That is, this IO is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3 etc. IN. So hope this is clear. Now let us consider the same thing. I1 is equal to V reference by 2 raised to 0 R into Dn minus 1. That is, the current through the resistor 2 raised to 0 R I1 is depending on Dn minus 1. Similarly, I2 is equal to V reference by 2 raised to 1 R into Dn minus 2. Then I3 is equal to V reference by 2 raised to 2 R into Dn minus 3. Etc. In, the nth resistor, In is equal to V reference by 2 raised to n minus 1 R into D0. So here you can see In is for least significant bit D0. That is, the current is V reference by 2 raised to n minus 1 R. So here we have very low current In. It is for least significant bit. Okay. Now, as I mentioned, IO, the output current IO, is the sum of all the input currents, that is I1 plus I2 plus I3 plus etc. IN. We know the expression of individual current I1, I2, I3 plus etc. IN. We can substitute the values, individual values, as V reference by 2 raised to 0 R into Dn minus 1 plus V reference by 2 raised to 1 R into Dn minus 2 etc. V reference by 2 raised to n minus 1 R into D0. Now, the output of the inverting amplifier, we know VO is equal to minus IO into RF. So here we can see a negative sign. This negative sign indicates it's an inverting amplifier. So here let us substitute the value of IO. So by substituting the value of IO, we get this expression, V reference by 2 raised to 0 R into Dn minus 1 plus V reference by 2 raised to 1 R into Dn minus 2 plus V reference by 2 raised to n minus 1 R into D0 into all multiplied by RF. RF is the feedback resistor. Okay. Then in this previous term, the common, we can check about the common parameter or common terms. So here, V reference is common to all the terms and RF is also common. Similarly, R, 2 raised to n minus 1 R, 2 raised to 1 R, etc. So R, V reference and RF, these three variables are common. So we can take that outside. So it is equal to V reference into RF by R into Dn minus 1 divided by 2 raised to 0. Plus Dn minus 2, 2 raised to 1, plus etc. D0, 2 raised to n minus 1. Now, taking the LCM, we get V reference into RF by R into Dn minus 1, 2 raised to n minus 1, plus Dn minus 2, 2 raised to n minus 2, plus etc. D0, 2 raised to 0, divided by 2 raised to n minus 1. That is, VO is equal to minus V reference into RF by R, Dn minus 1 to raise to n minus 1 plus Dn minus 2 to raise to n minus 2 plus etc. D0 to raise to 0 divided by 2 raised to n minus 1. Where n is the number of bits and V reference is the reference voltage. RF is the feedback resistor. And in the numerator, you can see V n minus 1 to raise to n minus 1 plus n minus 2 to raise to n minus 2 plus etc. d 0 to raise to 0. What is this? This is actually decimal equivalent of the binary data. You have studied in the third semester in LCPD conversions of data from binary to decimal or decimal to binary, etc. So here, this shows the decimal conversion, binary to decimal conversion. So this numerator can be written as decimal equivalent of the digital input. That is, VO is equal to minus V reference into RF by R into decimal equivalent of the digital input divided by 2 raised to n minus 1. Now, if RF equal to R, that is, if the resistor values are same, then VO is equal to minus V reference into decimal equivalent of D divided by 2 raised to n minus 1, because RF by R will become 1, where n is the number of bits in the digital input. So, as an example, so far we have discussed about the general case, n-bit binary DAC. Here you can see an example of 4-bit binary DAC. So, as I mentioned, for 4-bit binary DAC, we will have 4 resistors starting from 2 raised to R2, 2 raised to 3R, and MSB D3 is given to 2 raised to 0R, LSB D0 is given to 2 raised to 3R, and the expression is VO is equal to minus V reference into RF by R, D3 to raise to 3, D2 to power 2, plus D1 to power 1, plus D0 to power 0, divided by 2 raise to 3. So, it will be clear by doing a problem. So, consider a problem. So, for a 4-bit binary weighted DAC, RF by R is equal to 1. V reference equal to 16. Find out the analog output voltage corresponding to the digital input 0101. So here the question is very specific. That is, it is meant for a 4-bit binary weighted DAC. So you know the expression of an output voltage of a 4-bit binary weighted DAC. And in that, RF by R is also given. That is the one unknown, RF by R. That is also given as 1. Then V reference is given as 16 volt. Just simply by substituting these values in the output expression, we will get the answer. Let us see. So the expression of output voltage for a 4. D1 2 raised to 1 plus D0 2 power 0 divided by 2 power 3. So, by substituting the value of V reference as 60 and RF by R as 1, and you can substitute D3 as 0, D2 1, D1 0, and D0 1. By substituting all these values, so you will get VO corresponding to 0101 is minus 10 volt. So, if this particular, instead of asking like this, if it is asked to design a 4-bit binary weighted DAC with RF by R equal to 1 or V reference equal to 60 for the input 0101. So, if it is asked like that, then you have to design. You have to draw the circuit diagram for a 4-bit binary weighted DAC, and here you can see the input is 0101. Okay, that means MSB, this is D3, D2, D1, D0. So MSB D3 is connected to ground. Same time D2, since it is 1, it has to connect to V reference, and D1, the value of D1 is 0, so D1 also has to connect to ground, whereas the D0, the LSB is 1, so D0 has to connect to 0. So So if it is asked to design a circuit, you have to draw the circuit first. After that, use the output voltage expression, find out the analog voltage corresponding to the digital input. Now, coming to the advantage of binary weighted DAC. You know, the circuit is very simple. It has only resistors and one op-amp, and the resistor values, we should use n resistors whose values starting from 2⁻⁰ or to 2⁻⁻⁰ or. So the design is also very simple and circuit is also simple. That is the main advantage of binary weighted DAC. It is very simple in all aspects. But coming to the disadvantage, so here you can see, for n bit binary weighted DAC, we should use n resistors. No doubt, we have to use n resistors. But the value of resistor starting from 2⁻⁰ R to 2⁻⁰⁰ R. So this range, availability of this particular range is practically difficult. That is the main disadvantage of binary weighted DAC. So in order to solve this issue, we can use the another second type of DAC, which is known as R2R ladder DAC. So next, we can move on to the next DAC, that is R2R ladder DAC. Hope the thing that we have discussed so far is clear. If you have any doubt, please raise your doubt. I will try to make it clear. Hello?
Hello, ma'am. You have a query from us today.
Okay.
Is it okay to write the resolution as BFS by 2⁻⁴ instead of BFS by 2⁻⁰⁰?
No, it is 2⁻⁴.
Is it taking MSB resistors 2R and LSB as 2⁻⁴ in place of 2⁻⁹R?
Yes, you can use. Only the difference is the weight has to be increased by its binary weight. 2⁻⁰ or 2⁻⁰ Instead of that, you can use 2R, 2⁻⁰ or 2⁻⁰ There is no problem in using that.
Another doubt is, can you explain the disadvantages once again?
Okay. So let me explain now.
Yeah.
Okay. See, the disadvantage is, see, for n bit binary weighted DAC, see, let us come to the circuit diagram. So for NB binary weighted DAC, we should use the resistor value, different values of resistor. The number of resistor is limited, it is limited to N, but the resistor values, it stands from 2⁻⁰ R or R to 2⁻⁰⁰. The range, that is what I am speaking about. So the range is practically difficult to achieve, the availability of these resistor values. So, because we can't use some other resistors, instead of 2⁻⁴ R, we can't use 2⁻⁰ R. We can't use 2⁻⁰⁰ R. So, we have to use 2⁻⁰ R instead of that. So, that the practical difficulty is the availability of this wide range of values. That's only the disadvantage. So, the next one is R2R ladder DAC. So, as I mentioned, this particular DAC solved the disadvantage of binary weighted DAC. So, in the case of binary weighted DAC, we have to use a wide range of resistor values. Whereas, in this particular DAC, we should use only two values. One is R and another one is 2R. The value of R is, it's depending on you. You can choose any value of R, but you have to use the second resistor as 2R, two times the first one. So, depending on the number of bits, we can extend this with this R2R pair. So, here in this diagram, you can see 3-bit R2R ladder DAC. So, the same as I mentioned in the case of binary weighted DAC, the active component is op-amp. And it is also in the inverting mode. So, already I have explained about inverting mode configuration and non-inverting mode configuration. Here also this is working in inverting mode. So the output voltage is, anyway, there will be a phase difference of 180 degree between the input frame. And here, in the previous case, we have considered the current through the branch. But instead of that, here we are considering the voltage. So here we have an R to R ladder network. So we will analyze this particular network to find the output voltage corresponding to the bridge. So our first step is, see, you know, when we are applying a voltage at this particular point, that is inverting input of the op-amp, you know the output is equal to minus Rf by R into Vin. So that anyway you know. So our aim is to find the voltage at the equivalent voltage which is coming at the input of the inverting amplifier. For that we have to analyze this circuit using Thevenin's theorem. So here we are doing, we are converting this network, this R to R ladder network to its Thevenin equivalent. So the voltage corresponding to each bit V0, V1, V2 is obtained by analyzing or by converting the circuit into its Thevenin equivalent. And once we get all these three equivalent values, output values, then we can directly add, that is for V1 we will get V1 or VV0. Similarly, for V2 we will get VV2. And by adding all these values, you can get the equivalent output voltage. So let us try to analyze this R to R ladder network. That is, let us try to convert it its Thevenin's equivalent circuit. So here you can see the first diagram, leftmost. First diagram is the our ladder network. And one more thing. So here also you can see a switch. That is V0, V1, V2. Here we can see three switches similar to binary weighted DAC. So the connection of the switch is also same, exactly same. That is, when the value V0 is 1, the switch is connected to V reference. When the value V0 is 0, this is connected to ground. So the connection of the switch is exactly same what we discussed in the case of binary weighted DAC. So this is the first diagram is the R to R ladder network of our DAC. Now we have to convert this whole diagram into this Thevenin equivalent. Okay, I know you all are very familiar about converting a circuit or finding Thevenin and Norton equivalent. So here we are using only Thevenin theorem. So we are converting the network into its Thevenin equivalent. Okay, so here it's generally written as V0, V1, V2, and depending on the value of V0, V1, V2, we can connect it to V reference or ground. So, how to find the analog output or how to find the equivalent voltage, this Thevenin equivalent voltage VTH for V0. So, first we are trying to find the Thevenin equivalent voltage for V0. For that, V0 is equal to 1. And all other bits are 0. So this you have to be careful. That is, while finding out the Thevenin equivalent of a particular bit, you have to activate only that particular bit. You have to make 1 and you have to make all other bits are 0. Okay. So when we are finding the Thevenin equivalent of V0, we will make V0 is equal to 1 and V1 equal to 0, V2 is also 0. Consider the next diagram. So we have applied V1 is equal to 1. So the switch corresponding to, V0 is equal to 1. The switch corresponding to V0 is given to V reference. And V1 ground, V2 is also connected to ground. Now for this first section. So here you can see the Thevenin equivalent resistance RTH. How to find RTH? Here 2R and 2R connected in parallel. When two equivalent resistors are connected in parallel, the equivalent resistance is half of the resistance. So, in this particular portion, 2R and 2R are connected in parallel. So, the equivalent Thevenin resistance, right side you can see, the Thevenin resistance is R. Okay, now the voltage, Thevenin voltage is the voltage at this particular point. So, Thevenin voltage VTH is equal to V reference into 2R. V reference into 2R divided by sum. So you know the potential divider rule. So the applied voltage into that resistance divided by total resistance. So V reference divided into 2R divided by 2R plus 2R. That is 4R. So the voltage, this particular section is replaced as its Thevenin equivalent, V reference by 2 and the Thevenin resistance as R. Now, we replace this 2R, 2R ground V reference in this particular section by the Thevenin equivalent. So, here you can see the initial section R, 2R, V0, all these things we have replaced by its Thevenin equivalent, where the Thevenin voltage is V reference by 2 and the Thevenin resistance is R. Now, next is we should analyze, we should find the Thevenin equivalent of this particular section up to V1. So, here the Thevenin equivalent resistance RTH, you can see R plus R, 2R, and 2R and 2R parallel. So, when 2R and 2R parallel, the equivalent resistance is R. Similarly, V reference by 2 is the applied voltage. So, here the voltage is V reference by 2 into 2R divided by 4R. That is V reference by 4. Hope it's clear. Now, in the next section, what we'll do is this V Thevenin equivalent is replaced, or the ladder network is replaced by the Thevenin equivalent. So, Thevenin voltage is V reference by 4, resistance is R. Then, again we can find the Thevenin equivalent. So, here the Thevenin resistance 2R, then 2R, R plus R 2R. So, 2R and 2R in parallel. So, the equivalent resistance is R. And the voltage V reference by 4 is applied voltage. So, the Thevenin voltage is V reference by 2, that is V reference by 8. So, the whole this R2R network we have replaced by a simple Thevenin circuit. So, here the input voltage is V reference by 8 and the resistance is R. Now, you can see it's a very simple inverting amplifier. See, very simple inverting amplifier with feedback resistor RF, input resistance R, and the applied voltage V reference by 8. So, the output voltage VO corresponding to VO, that is VBO, is equal to minus V reference by 8 into RF by R. So, when VO is equal to 1. When VO is equal to V0 is equal to 0, the voltage corresponding to that is 0. That is, when V0 LSB bit is 1, the voltage corresponding to that LSB bit is minus V reference by 8 into RF by R. So, in the previous case, similar to the previous case, here also the voltage is directly connected to the bit. There, the current is directly connected to the bit. So, here VB0, that is VB0 is equal to minus V reference by 8 into, sorry, there is RF by R into RF by R into V0. Similarly, VB1 and VB2. VB1 is minus V reference by 4 into RF by R into V1. And VB2 is minus V reference by 2 into RF by R into V2. And by adding all these things, all these voltages, VO is equal to VB0 plus VB1 plus VB2. So, by adding all these three voltages, we will get VO as minus V reference into RF by R into V0 2 raised to 0 plus V1 2 raised to 1 plus V2 2 raised to 2 all divided by 2 power 3. So, this is the expression of the output voltage for a R2R ladder DAC. Now, depending on our requirement, we can substitute the values of V0, V1, V2, etc., V reference and RF by R, etc. So, it will be more clear by doing a problem. So, let us see how to do a problem. So, the problem is find out the output voltage of a 4-bit R2R ladder DAC whose RF, here it is given as RF is equal to 3R. That means RF by R is equal to 3. For the digital input 0100, if the reference voltage is 2.5 volt. Now, we know the expression, that is for 4 bits R2R ladder DAC, output voltage VO is equal to minus V reference into RF by R into V0 2 raised to 0 plus V1 2 raised to 1 plus V2 2 raised to 2 plus V3 2 raised to 3 divided by 2 raised to 4. Here, see, normally students make a mistake as, so you can see the input is written like this 0100. Actually, this 0 is MSB, the leftmost 0 is MSB. For 4-bit DAC, this MSB is B3. So, leftmost digit is B3 and rightmost is B0. See the expression, the first term is starting with B0, correct? So, normally what the student will do is, this B0, the value of B0 will be taken from the first value. See here, both B0 and B3 is 0. So, it won't make much difference. But, see, if this particular MSB bit is 1 and if LSB is 0, so here B0 you have to substitute this LSB value 0. Okay, so, eppadum kaanunna oru prashnane, direct ezhuthuka. 0100 ennallathu expression lote direct ezhuthuka. So, ivide sradhikkanda karyam, LSB edha, MSB edha. You have to be very careful while substituting. So, first term is for LSB. Okay. So, V reference into RF by R, V0 2 raised to 0 plus V1 2 raised to 1 plus V2 2 raised to 2 plus V3 2 raised to 3 divided by 2 raised to 4. Now, let us substitute the value. So, RF by R, RF it is given as 3R. So, substitute 3R by R. So, the answer is 1.875. Now, see, instead of directly asking the question like this, if it is asked to design, similar what we are discussed in the case of binary weighted DAC, if it is asked to design a 4-bit R2R ladder DAC whose RF is 3R and the input is 0100, reference voltage is also given as 2.5. So, if it is asked to design and find out the output voltage, then first you have to do the design. So, design, you know, design means it's a making of circuit diagram, or finally after design you have to get a circuit diagram. So, simply drawing the circuit diagram itself is the design for this DAC. So, for 0100, you can design or draw the circuit like this, and this is the circuit diagram for a 4-bit DAC with input 0100. So, here you can see MSB is 0, that is B3 is 0, so it has to connect to ground. Then V2 is 1, so V2 has to connect to V reference. Then V1 is 0, so V1 also has to be connected to ground. Then V0, LSB is also 0. So this is the circuit diagram for the 4-bit R2R ladder DAC with the given specification. So if it is asked to design, you have to draw the design first and then draw the output. It's very simple. So you be very careful while doing this. That's all. So while doing exam, university examination, you can score 100% mark for this particular problem. Once you are clear the concept, so it's not possible to find out the circuit diagram. You have to understand how we can draw the circuit diagram. So that is why I started from the amplifier section. So, the procedure of drawing the circuit diagram is very important. So, you know, electronic circuit, it's not easy to by heart the circuit diagram. So, first, I already mentioned that how to draw the circuit diagram. First, you have to draw the amplifier inverting mode. Then, you have to draw the circuit then fill the circuitry, required circuit. So that's all about R2R ladder DAC. Then coming to the advantage, it doesn't have any disadvantages, it has only advantages. Coming to the advantages, it is very easy to build as only two resistor values are required. Whereas in the case of binary weighted DAC, we should require n resistors with different values. And the values also should be very specific, power of 2. And here, it's very simple, easy to build because we require only two resistor values. So the 2 stands for the resistor values, not for the number of resistors. So the number of bits can be expanded by adding more sections of R to R pair. So here you can see in this particular diagram. So if it is 5 bit, what you have to do? We have to add this R to R pair one more here. And if it is only 3 bits, what you have to do? We have to just cut one R to R pair. So that's all. So it's very easy to expand depending on the number of bits. So that's about the DAC. I hope the session was useful.
In R1 equal to V reference by 2R equation, why V multiplied by B?
Okay, it's for the first. Okay. So I hope the question it was why D is coming there. Am I correct? Please listen, I can explain once more. So in this particular diagram, you can see the current is depending on the resistor value. So you know, if a resistor, we are applying a voltage to a resistor, the current through the resistor is depending on the resistor value, that is V by R. So there is no doubt in that. Now, the voltage, how can we apply a voltage to this particular resistor? It is depending on the bit. Let us say first, you just consider the first resistor, 2 raised to 0 R. And there is the resistor is corresponding to the MSB bit, that is Dn minus 1. So here we are using a switch. Depending on the value of this bit, MSB bit, that is, if this MSB bit is 1, then the resistor, one end of the resistor has to connect to reference voltage. If it is 0, then it has to connect to ground. So that is the relationship between current and the bit. That is, if this Dn minus 1 is 1, then the current is V reference by 2 raised to 0 R. If it is 0, then the current is 0. So both case we have to consider. That is why there is a term D. Hope it's clear.
You explained about analog adder principle of the op-amp being used as the DA converter. This requires n bit output from this microcontroller. Could you explain converting signal digital value from using digital bit? Using bit digital output to analog value output.
Single bit ആണ് തോന്നുന്നു ഉദ്ദേശിച്ചത്. ഇത് n bit അല്ലേ ഞാൻ നമ്മൾ പറഞ്ഞത്. അപ്പൊ സിംഗിൾ ബിറ്റ് ആണെങ്കിൽ
ഔട്ട്പുട്ട് സമയം മൈക്രോ കൺട്രോളർ ആണ് മാം.
അതെ അതെ.
ഔട്ട്പുട്ട് സമയം.
അപ്പൊ സിംഗിൾ ബിറ്റ് ഡിഎസി ഉപയോഗിച്ചാൽ മതി. പക്ഷെ അതിന് നമ്മൾ ഈ ബൈനറി വെയിറ്റഡ് ഡിഎസി ഒന്നല്ല ഉപയോഗിക്കാം. ഹൈ ലെവൽ ഞാൻ ആദ്യം തന്നെ പറഞ്ഞ ഡിഫറെന്റ് ടൈപ്സ് ഓഫ് ഡിഎസി. അത്രയും ഹൈ ലെവൽ ഡിഎസിസ് നിങ്ങളുടെ ഇതിനകത്ത് സിലബസിൽ വരാത്തതുകൊണ്ട് മാത്രമാണ് ഈ രണ്ട് സെക്ഷൻ മാത്രം.
In the design of 4-bit R2R, the resistor connected to the leftmost side is 2R. Is it R or 2R?
2R. This last 2R is, see the circuit diagram, 3-bit R2R ladder DAC. This 2R, last 2R is for balance in the whole circuit. So this is always 2R. It's not a mistake, it is 2R only. So that also you have to be very careful. It's not R, it is 2R.
Okay, thank you, ma'am, for your participation. Thank you so much. It was a really useful session. Hope all the students enjoyed the session. Thank you for the participation. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, Asa, for having a session like this.
Thank you, ma'am, and thank you, students.
Okay, thank you very much.